Nick C. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. Nick, to unmute yourself. And what's your question for Anna Maria Clement?
Yes. Hello, Anna Maria. I've been in the Hippocrat a while ago. I have a question for you.
Okay.
Hello. Brian said that it was not good to eat salt, you know, whatever the salt. But I was wondering about the bath. Is it good if we go in the bath and we put Epsom salt or sea salt in the bath? Because Absolutely. The body was acclimated.
Yeah. So that is the bath that we would suggest is like a cup of sea salt, dead sea salt, Epsom salt. And then maybe add, actually what we do, we add a pound of baking soda to help to clean up radiation we got during the day, heavy metals. And we put aromatherapy oils in there and a few drops of that. And it's a great thing, twice a week. It's absolutely fantastic to clean up and clean. You know, we also do, of course, we have far infrared saunas that are such a great help to perspire and clean up heavy metals and chemicals and radiation.
Yeah. Thank you, Anna Maria.
No, you're right. You're right.
Thank you. Up next, we have Sophia. Sophia, if you can go ahead and unmute yourself.
Hi, doctor. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. My question, please, is about supplements. And as I live in Canada, and I would like to know about a reliable brand where I can get CBD oil, if you can help me, please. Also, you mentioned in your previous lecture about a supplement you order from Canada that helps with the vision and health in general.
Yeah, so in Canada, I mean, you have a lot of CBD in Canada. My goodness, you I'm sure you can find a good source. There's a lot of stores in Canada that has good CBD. We carry CBD too, but that absolutely you can find in Canada. And what a great help. Brian and I take it every day too. And when it comes to just supplements overall, of course, B12 is a plant-based, soil-based B12. It's very important, vitamin D. We take digestive enzymes every day. We take systemic enzymes and we take probiotics. So things like that, I mean, there are so many special supplements. If you really want to work on the brain, you have omega-3, but not from fish oil. Fish oil is rancid crap, literally. You should never use fish oil. I always joke, do you think a fish is just pouring oil out of itself? No, you squeeze the oil out of it. It's awful. So it's everything that comes with it. But you need essential fatty acid. You need omega-3s from all the foods. And of course, blue-green algae, which you can find, live algae. And you can take chlorella to help with that. And of course, the nuts. The only nuts we don't use is peanuts and cashew, as they have actually a fungus that could be carcinogenic. So it's called an aflatoxin. And so all the other nuts, the walnuts, of course, is the highest in omega-3. And do I need a bag full? No, a little palm full of walnuts go a long way. And then, of course, I have sprouted beans and I have sprouted grains and so on. That gives me good brain food. So it's kind of whatever is good for my body is good for my heart and my brain.
Thank you, Anna Maria. Up next we have, and I hope I'm pronouncing this correctly, Alicia or Alicia. If you go ahead and unmute yourself, please.
Hello, how are you today?
I'm so good.
This was absolutely wonderful. And I just want to attend many, many more. But my question is to you, how do you improve kidney function and a partial thyroidectomy?
Mm-hmm. So a lot of people come here with that. And so it's a vascular problem, which means this is the perfect diet for kidney problem. So, you know, when it comes to the sodium, potassium, of course, we don't add salt to our food. Our food are perfect with sodium, potassium. So that's not a problem. The green juice, the orange green juice, you know, we don't, we have had enough sugar for a lifetime, so we don't add carrots and beets. If I have a child, I can add maybe a carrot or half an apple into the juice, but as adults, we definitely stay out of that now, because as you saw, sugar feeds every problem under the sun, diabetes, obesity, cancer, you name it. So it's more getting onto a life diet. The more raw you eat, the better your kidneys are going to do. And the same with thyroid. So if you have a partial thyroidectomy, which, you know, so many people have now, and you are on medication, you're either Synthroid or Armor, you know, you're on something, then the diet needs to support you. The iodine and castor oil could be a mix that you put a little bit of castor oil in the palm of your hand, a drop of iodine. We use 100% ionic iodine here. Rub it on and rub it on your neck. So you mix it in the palm of your hand, rub it on your neck to help. And that goes behind and in front of your thyroid. Thyroid, of course, you know if you have a problem because it's the fatigue and not sleeping, not having energy. And it takes care, because thyroid is the master gland, big time. And it takes care of metabolism, absorption of protein, absorption of oxygen and cholesterol into your cells, your growth rate. So many things that when that's off, we need to support it best we can. Seaweed can support it. It depends on if I'm hyper or hypo. A lot of people have come here with Hashimoto. Hashimoto is not a normal, it's called an autoimmune problem. But the way that we would treat that is, of course, naturally now, a lot of endocrinologists are not treating it with medication, Hashimoto. And we just had an expert here in thyroid, and he said something interesting. And he's you can all sign up for our magazine digitally on our website. And you can read it, all the magazines and all the stories and all of that. But he said his first advice before somebody does something with their thyroid and medication would be, if you can't lose weight, don't blame the thyroid. If you can't sleep, don't blame the thyroid. If you don't have energy, don't blame the thyroid. So the deal is, start lifestyle first and see how far that goes. If that's not enough, maybe you need some help. So in your case, you have a partial, which is great. So you have a partial thyroid, and that should function enough, especially on our lifestyle. So that should be enough. And you know, this has been what we see here. And so vascular problem like kidney, perfect for our problem, perfect. And so is thyroid problem.